Aleluia. Glory to Jesus. Makatore mazuka pe kataya katabaya katabaya. Zizeke ke kaposa kalayata rabu zuka paya. Glory to God, glory to God in the highest. Jire kate bobo suka baya. Pahra katazosh. We are here again tonight. We give God the praise, we give God the glory. We thank him for another time in his presence. May his name be glorified, may his name be magnified in the highest. Oh, we thank him for last week when we had this session of prayer. We thank him for his miracle. We thank him for his blessings in our life. Oh, he's a good God. Father, we worship you, Lord. We give you all the praise. We give you all the glory. Hallelujah to your name, Lord. Masata liketo baya. Zerekete kapapo sukaba. You are worthy to be praised. You are worthy to be adored. Oh, Father, no one like you. You are the mighty man of war. You are the great I am. Let's go ahead and worship him and give him glory tonight. Let's bless his holy name. Let's magnify him. There is no one like him. He's higher than the highest. He's better than the best. He's the reason for our living. He's the one who has kept us to be alive again tonight. Not by our power, not by our might. Oh Lord, you are good. And your mercies endure forever. Be thou exalted. This is another time of worship and another time of worship and prayer. Go ahead and worship him, give him glory, magnify him. Miroko tuze ke pete 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 pete. La cambre ke tu zuzush. Go ahead and worship him, give him praise, magnify his holy name. There is no one like him. Mase ke te boyo doroba ya gadaba ya. He is the mighty God in battle. He is the greater Ham. He is the leader of the valley. He is the Lord of hosts. Meso koto koto. Yambre kataba ya gadash. Magnify the Lord. Magnify him. Go ahead and worship him tonight. Go ahead and worship him tonight. Go ahead and worship him. Let's give him glory. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hosanna. Hosanna. Hosanna to the Lord God Almighty in the highest. Lord, we worship you. Rakata baya baya baya. Lord God of worship. We worship you, Lord. You are better than the best. You are greater than the greatest. You are higher than the highest. Father, we worship you, Lord. In the name of Jesus. Father, we worship you, Lord. We bless holy name in the name of Jesus. Father, we worship you. Father, we worship you, Lord. Kapaya gozuke prekete gadaya. Worship him, give him glory, magnify his holy name. You can take your own song and just use it to magnify him. You can take your own song and just use it to magnify him. Oh, kapaya ndoroza prekete baya gadaba. Yurekete bebese katabaya gadaba yaba yaba. Yikrekete kete kete kete. Lord, we worship you. We worship you, Lord. Makata baya gaba baba basa kata yada baya ba. Yurekete baso kaprekete kete kete kete. Lord, we worship you. We worship you. We worship you. We worship you. Glory, glory, glory in the highest. Glory, glory, glory in the highest. Honor, dominion, majesty to your name, O God. Blessed be your name tonight. We worship you, Lord. Be thou exalted. Be thou exalted. Father, we worship you. We worship you. Lord, there is no one like you. There is no one like you in the name of Jesus. Rakata basa kata bogo sekete baya gadaba. Rega babo zokoto godu baga daba daba daba. Lord, we worship you, Lord. You are too faithful to fail me. You are too faithful to fail us. You are too faithful to fail us. It doesn't matter what the situation of the world is right now. It doesn't matter what the circumstance of the world is right now. You are too faithful to fail your own. You don't fail. Father, we worship you. We worship you. We worship you. We worship you. We give all the glory. We give all the honor. We bless your holy name in the name of Jesus. Father, we worship you, Lord. We magnify you tonight in the name of Jesus. Father, we worship you, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Lord, we worship you, Lord. Father, we worship you, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Father, we worship you. Take all the glory in the name of Jesus. Father, we worship you, Lord. Father, we worship you, Lord. We give you glory. Le kataza sokete baya papa baya. Yeke popo sokoto baya gada baba baba shaka da baya ba. Yure kete baka sakala baya gada baya ba. Lord, we worship you. We give all the praise. We give all the glory. We give all the honor. In the name of Jesus. You are worthy, you are worthy, you are worthy. Father God Almighty, you are the strength of our lives. You are the strength of our lives. You are the strength of our lives. Our hearts shall not fear. It doesn't matter what is happening. It doesn't matter what coronavirus is doing. Our hearts shall not fear, oh God. Our hearts shall not fear. We trust in you. The Bible says that trust in the Lord shall be as Mount Zion. That shall not be removed. Father, we worship you. We give all the praise. We give all the honor. In the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we worship you, Lord. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. 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 Yes, Lord. Holy fire burn upon my altar. Holy fire burn upon my altar. Holy fire burn upon my altar tonight. Holy fire burn upon my altar tonight. Holy fire burn upon my altar tonight, Lord. Lord, set me on fire for you, O God. Set me on fire for you, O God. Set me on fire for you, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Father, God Almighty, in the name of Jesus, I give you praise, I give you praise. Thank you for finding something you can use in my life. Thank you for finding something you can use in my little life, oh God. Thank you, you still find something you can use, oh God. Thank you, Father, God Almighty. Blessed be your name, blessed be your name. Holy fire, soul, burn upon my altar. Ye kapasekete boyo goloba yagada bayaba. Le kateza koko kopepehe. Re kata bayaba yaba yaba yaba. If you can pray in the language of the Holy Spirit, just go ahead and bless your tongue. Le halida. Le Like brokotoza katabaya, rekataka sakatabaya gada godo godo godo. Set yourself on fire, oh by the Holy Ghost. Rekatababa baba, yeketozi katabaya. Oh, thank you, Holy Spirit. Makasa katababa baba, lekatozu katabaya gada ba. Holy fire burn upon my altar. Holy fire burn upon my heart tonight. Burn upon my soul. The Spirit of the Living God. Take over my spirit, take over my soul tonight in the name of Jesus. Oh, I lift up my hands unto you, Lord. I lift up my hands unto you, Lord God Almighty. Oh, God Almighty, in the name of Jesus. I cannot do it by myself unless you take over. I cannot do anything unless you set me on fire. Without you, I am nothing. Holy Ghost, set me on fire tonight. Let's go ahead and tell them, Lord, set me on fire. As I pray, let my voice be heard. Let my voice be heard in the throne room of God. Let my voice be heard in the throne room of the Jehovah. Let the heaven pay attention to me. Let the heaven pay attention to my voice tonight. It's a battle of voices tonight. It's a battle of voices. Lift up your voice. Lift up your voice. Lift up your voice. Reprate passo que te pa, neke prekete que te kete, leka prekete koto koto, reka pahali, reka tuzese que te kete, grande kato skapahali, rekete que te kete, rakata baya da, zeri kato zoko koto 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 shiga. Pare kataya, rejus kande ketuya, e popo ke pepe kete kete kete, leka preke te veyebu. Never allow the voices of your enemies to be louder than your voice. Ika bayaka ta bayaba yaba, reke te se kete boyo bodo bayaba. Holy fire, burn upon my altar. Holy fire, burn upon this temple. Holy fire, sanctify this temple tonight. Purify this temple in the name of Jesus. Holy fire, purify this temple. Sanctify this temple in the name of Jesus. Holy Spirit, move within me. Holy Spirit, move within me. Sanctify me. Sanctify me. Purify me. Bless me. Make me honor. Make me useful. Anything that can insulate your power. Anything that can pull down your power tonight. In my life, Father, remove that. Let the current of the Holy Ghost flow through me in the name of Jesus. As it flows through me, Lord, let it flow to your people. Oh, under this corporate anointing, let there be miraculous, O God. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Oh, Gabaya, Reka prekete susu kudi baya gada gada. Leka papo koto. Reka daga sagada. Yo, press. For the next 5 minutes, we are still going to be pressing the spirit. Press in the spirit. The Bible says in Jude verse 20, build up yourself upon your most holy faith. Pray in the Holy Ghost. Pray in the spirit. In the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord. Holy fire. Beka ba 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 se kataya darosha. Eketo koto koto bayaga da bayaba. Ekatabaya, yeke puso toruba, yeka paria, li trekete zus, rekatabaya, rekatuzasha, yekata, li prokotobasa katabaya. Yes. Mekata baposo toria, ekete keke bebe seke debo Yike bobo so katabaya gadagadagada. Yike bobo so sumpere bayanga dabaya. Yike bobo so kebe bobo se kede bolo. Yes, Lord. Yike bobo se katabaya bayaba. Yike bobo se kede bobo se kede bo yegegegegegegegegegegegegegegegege. Yike bobo se kababababasa katabaya gadabadabadabadaba. Yes. Yeke bobo so tono bayaga dabababababa. Meke bobo so koto bayaga dabayabayabayaba. Yes. Likatoza paya, rekatabayaba. I have confidence in the Lord that as we pray tonight, heaven is open. Heaven is open already. Your heaven is open. Heaven's open over tonight's prayer. We have that confidence that we are entering into the Holy of Holies tonight. We have that confidence we are approaching the throne of grace tonight, and we are taking everything that we can take. We are seizing everything we can seize. We are possessing everything we can possess. Lika preketo soto yoba rabaya. He said, the house of Jacob, I will cause the house of Jacob to seek me, but not in vain. Masute yenga daba yaga daba. Rekatata poso. Oh, yeah. No badezu que to baba yaga da bayaga da bayaba. Ye que bobo soto le bayaba baba. Ye que bobo se de boye de boye de boye de boye. Ni baba 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 baba. Ye katoze te beye 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 beye. Ye que bobo so ka breke te bayaga da bayaba. This atmosphere has become the atmosphere of Jesus. And every atmosphere of Jesus is atmosphere of miracles. Every atmosphere of Jesus is atmosphere of power. Atmosphere of Jesus is atmosphere of signs. Atmosphere of Jesus is atmosphere of deliverance. Atmosphere of Jesus is atmosphere of grace. Atmosphere of Jesus is atmosphere of mercy. This is atmosphere of Jesus. This is atmosphere of Jesus. Malika to zeke preke te bayanga la baya. Ronde pasata ya baya. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jehovah. Yes. This is the atmosphere of Jesus. Yes. Yes, Lord. Yes, 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 yes. Yes. No disease is incurable. In the atmosphere of Jesus. Nothing is impossible in the atmosphere of Jesus. No addiction that Jesus cannot break in his atmosphere. No disease that he cannot heal in his atmosphere. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Pray now that, Lord, let my atmosphere right now become your atmosphere. Let the atmosphere of my house become your atmosphere. Let my atmosphere become your atmosphere. Oh Lord Jesus. Let my atmosphere become your atmosphere. In the name of Jesus. Yes. Yes, Lord. 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 Let this my atmosphere become the atmosphere of Jesus. Yes. Mesu katayanto. Epa prekoto. Ye katakatakatakatakatakata. Yes. Oh God, yo katabayaba. There is nothing God cannot move in his atmosphere. In his atmosphere, no devil can stand it. No Satan can stand the atmosphere of Jesus. No power of darkness can stand the atmosphere of Jesus. No witch, no wizard, no astral projector can stand the atmosphere of Jesus. No magician can stand the atmosphere of Jesus. No sorcerer can stand the atmosphere of Jesus. No power of darkness can stand the atmosphere of Jesus. Yes. The Bible says, at the mention of the name of Jesus, every knee should bow. Of the things in heaven, the things in the earth, the sin of them in the earth. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. This is your atmosphere, Lord. This is your atmosphere, Lord. Yes, yes, Lord. When nothing is impossible. Oh, kapa. No disease incurable. Ye katabaya. No disease is incurable. Nothing is impossible. She katayanda. Ma preke tosa katabaya. Yes. Yes. Yes, 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 yes. Paparot. Ye katayaka reke sukoro koto bayaka da bayaba daba. Ratande de su te fili baya. Yin reke te kese kete bayaka da bayaka da bayaka da bayaka da bayaka. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. This is your atmosphere, Lord. This atmosphere is your atmosphere. Holy Ghost, take control. In the name of Jesus. This is your atmosphere, Lord. Kapayande kusi kadayande. E pambo kutu wa yanga daba yanga daba yaba. Thank you, Abba Father. Blessed be your name tonight. Lord, we worship you. Lord, we give you all the praise. Lord, we give you all the honor. In the mighty name of Jesus. Be thou exalted. Lord, as we continue tonight, oh Lord, please continue with us. Take control, let your name be glorified. Bless every one of us on this platform tonight, and do not allow our lives to remain the same. In your atmosphere, no disease is incurable, nothing is impossible. Oh Father God Almighty, your atmosphere is atmosphere of miracle. Your atmosphere is atmosphere of answers to prayer. Your atmosphere is atmosphere of deliverance. Your atmosphere is atmosphere of open doors. Your atmosphere is atmosphere of grace and mercy. Lord, as we continue, let us see your power. Let us see your glory. Let the power manifest. The power that you have put in us. The grace you have released upon us. You have released upon us. Let it manifest in the name of Jesus. Lord God Almighty, by tonight's prayer, let everyone have testimony. Let everyone have testimony in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Holy Ghost, for we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. By the grace of God, I just want to give us an exhortation. Then we go into the session of prayer tonight. The exhortation. As I was praying before the Lord early hours of this morning, around that 3 a.m., as I was praying, and the Lord laid this word into my heart. And that is the word we are going to be praying, we're using to pray tonight. And the word is silencing the voice of the adversary. Silencing the voice of the adversary. Brethren, adversary is real. Adversary is real. And one of the adversaries that we can see presently is coronavirus. We can see it's very real. Adversary is real. It doesn't matter what anybody believes in. Adversary is very, very real. There is no fake when it comes to the issue of adversary. Silencing the voice of adversary. That is to say, silencing the voice of the enemy. Silencing the voice of adversary. So we are going to be, the Bible says, I will read 1 Peter chapter 5 verse 8. 1 Peter chapter 5 verse 8. The Bible says, be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, not because of your friend, the devil. Because of your adversary, the devil. The Bible now says further, as a roaring lion, walketh about, seeking whom he may devour. I'll be paying attention to as a roaring lion. Anytime Satan roars, or anytime lion roars, there is always a voice or a sound. What makes other animals in the jungle, when lion roars, what makes other animals to begin to look for safety is the sound they had. Animals in the jungle, they can differentiate between the voice of an elephant and the voice of a giraffe and the voice of a porcupine and the voice of hippo and from the voice of a lion. When hippo blows the water the mother blows from their nostrils in the dump there, no animal runs away. It doesn't matter. But when lion roars in the jungle, kapaulu kese kapia gadaba, even kilometers away, animals will be looking for safety. By privilege, I was able to be somewhere in Kenya then. It is called Masai Mara. It's a park. It's a natural park. We saw lion. When lion was coming, the lioness, when this lioness was walking majestically, even without minding any animals around, buffaloes, they were panicking. And then the tall guy told us that the lioness had eaten. That when lion is full, lion doesn't kill. So the lioness just passed by the buffaloes that were ready for a showdown with the lioness. The lioness just walked away. Brethren, what am I trying to say? Even animals far distance away, when they sighted this lioness coming, they run away. I don't know the voice that is tormenting you tonight. Are you listening to the voice of God? or you are listening to the voice of adversary. That is where I'm going. Brethren, adversary is real. And I want to let us know the following tonight before we go into the session of prayer. An adversary is not a friend. That is why it is called adversary. Adversary is an enemy. It doesn't matter how they polish it. Adversary is an enemy. Let that one be at the back of your mind or at the center of your mind. An adversary doesn't want anything good for you. Let that one be the second one. An adversary wants to make sure that you don't have a testimony of good things to share. I want you to register that one also. An adversary wants to celebrate your downfall. An adversary is that person or is that personality that is waiting for your downfall in order for them to celebrate. Adversary celebrates when somebody who is their target or their victims falls. Adversary is that person who wants to jubilate at your failure. Adversary is that person who wants you dead at all costs. And that will lead me to the next Bible passage before we pray tonight. That will lead me to the next Bible passage. An adversary is that person, is that personality, is that devil who wants you dead at all costs. All what they want for you is to die. All what they want for you is not to fulfill destiny. All what they want for you is not to have that testimony. All what they want for you is not to have a good thing to share about your life and family. All what they want is for you to wake up in the morning with bad news and call them on phone and still give them the bad news of your life so that they can have something to celebrate during the day. That devil is a bastard. Hallelujah. Luke chapter 23. I looked at this word of God so much. This word of God in the book of Luke chapter 23. And I was looking at the life of my Lord and my Savior, Jesus Christ. During his trial before Pilate. I saw it. Holy Spirit opened my eyes to see that Bible passage. And I turned into prayer for my life. No, the Bible passage started. But I will just read only 20. Let me read from verse 18 quickly. The Bible says, and they cried out all at once. Remember, when they cried out, what were they raising? They were raising their voices. They cried out all at once, saying, away with this man, and release unto us Barabbas. Release unto us Barabbas. Who for a certain sin, the Bible now was explaining who Barabbas was. Who for a certain sedition made in the city and for murder was cast into the prison. That is the personality of Barabbas. But that's not my issue tonight. Pilate therefore willing to release Jesus, spake again to them. But no, Pilate wanted to release Jesus. Pilate didn't want to kill Jesus. It was not his intention for Jesus to die by his hand or to die by any means that enemies wanted to use to kill him. And mind you, Pilate did not have anything against him. I am not talking about the messianic aspect of Jesus Christ tonight. I'm talking about the man Jesus standing before another man like him. I pray for somebody tonight that a man like you will not succeed in taking your life. In the mighty name of Jesus. The Bible says in Luke chapter 23, verse 21. But they cried saying, crucify him! Crucify him! It's a voice. They raised their voice. They cried saying, crucify him! Crucify him! They raised their voices up. The voices of adversary went up. Look at what happened in verse 22. And he said unto them the third time. Pilate said unto them, now the third time, What evil had he done? What evil have you done to that person? Who wants you dead at all costs? That person who wants you destroyed at all costs. What evil have you done to that person? That was the case of this man.
on the man Jesus here. I have found no cause of death in him. This man supposed not to die. This is a young man that is living his life, doing miracles in town, even not even causing trouble to my kingdom, to my office. But now you have brought him before me for me to make a judgment and get him killed. Look at what happened. He said, I will therefore chastise him and let him go. I want to flog him. I will flog him. If you want me to flog him, I will flog him. I will let him go. I'm going to discipline him. I want to chastise him. I'm not going to kill him. I want to chastise him. That was what Pilate was telling them. Now, look at what people said in verse 23. And they were incited with loud voices. They were incited. Ah, Pilate, if you don't kill this boy today, we will burn down this palace. We don't mind the number of people that soldiers will kill here. We are going to burn down this palace. This guy must die. That was the voice they were raising against Jesus. I don't know that person. I don't know that personality that I've said, until you die, they will not eat, like they did to Apostle Paul. That some people put themselves on oath and they fasted. They fasted that until they kill Apostle Paul, they will not eat. I pray for somebody tonight in the name of Jesus. Anybody that has put himself or herself on a demonic oath over your life, that until they kill you, that they will not rest. I decree they will die their death. You will not die their death. In the name of Jesus. Look at what verse 23 says. And they were instant with loud voices. Not only one now. They were instant with loud voices. There was an uproar of voices. There were many voices in that place. Even if anyone is saying that they should release Jesus, they wouldn't even hear anything again. There were a lot of voices in that place. They were instant. They were doing it right there. They were not going home to send their words. They want that word right now. They were prompt. They want it immediately. And the Bible says, requiring that he might be crucified. Are they going to crucify somebody and the person will not die? The person will definitely die. Brethren, let's go for that quickly because of our time, so that we can pray tonight. And the voices of them, look at it again. And the voices of them, and the voices of them, you can see the battle of voices, and the voices of them. And the voices of them, and the voices of them, and of the chief priest prevailed. I pray for somebody tonight. The voices of your enemies will not prevail over your life. It means there were people that were saying in that place, don't crucify him. Don't crucify him. Don't kill this guy. He's innocent. But the Bible says the voices of them and the voices of the adversary, the voices of the high priest, the voices of them, they didn't even tell us the name of the them, the voices of them and of the chief priests. You can see they are not one. Chief priests prevailed. I pray the voice of the enemy, the voices of the enemy shall not prevail over your family. The voices of the wicked shall not prevail over your home. The voices of the wicked shall not prevail over your health. The voices of the wicked shall not prevail over your finances. In the mighty name of Jesus. The Bible says, and the voices of them. Who are those them in your life? Who are those evil people around your life that they are raising evil voices against you? They are raising false accusations against your destiny. They want you dead at all costs. I decree in the name of Jesus, every voice of crucifying him against your life tonight, Holy Ghost shall silence them. The fire of God shall silence them in the name of Jesus. Then I will read verse 24. The Bible says, and Pilate gave sentence that it should be as they required. I pray for somebody. Your life will not be as the enemies required. I pray for somebody tonight, even including myself. Our lives shall not dance to the tunes of the enemies. Our lives shall not be subjected to the dictates of the wicked. That was what the Bible says. The life of Jesus Christ was subjected to the dictates of the wicked. The life of Jesus Christ was subjected to the dictates of the enemies. Because the Bible says the voice of them prevailed. The voice of them and that of the chief priests prevailed. Pray for somebody tonight. The voices of the wicked shall not prevail in your life. In the mighty name of Jesus. I don't know any area of your life where you are struggling. I don't know any area of your life where there are troubles. Maybe you look at your right, you look at your left. Troubles all around you. Tonight, Holy Ghost will rescue you. In the name of Jesus. Holy Ghost will rescue you. In the name of Jesus. Then I will read verse 25. The Bible says in verse 25, as as he released unto them him that for sedition and murder was cast into prison, whom they desired.
Look at the last verse, the last word there. But he delivered Jesus to their will. I think it's in your Bible like that. If you are reading King James, it will be like that in your Bible. He delivered Jesus to their will. He delivered Jesus to the will of his enemies. He delivered Jesus to the will of those who should kill him. He delivered Jesus to the will of those who should destroy his life. He delivered Jesus to the will of those who didn't want him to be alive. He delivered Jesus to the will of the adversaries. That was what Pilate did. Then the question now in my heart is, who was now at fault? Was it the people who cried, crucify him, or the man who delivered him to the dictate of their will? Who should we blame now? I am not talking about the issue of Jesus resurrecting from the dead now. Jesus resurrected, we know. God had the joker when they were doing all those things. I'm not talking about that tonight. I'm not talking about the gospel aspect of it. I'm talking about the man Jesus now. Man like you, like me, standing before the judge, standing in the community, and he was arrested, and he was beaten, he was disciplined, and the judge wanted to let him go, wanted to give him some fines, that don't do what they said you did again. But they said, no, the solution to the atrocity of this guy is to kill him. We are going to be praying tonight, brethren. I want to tell you one more time. Adversaries have voices. The voices of the wicked, are real. Let no man deceive you. Let no man make you think that maybe if you are in North America, there is no enemy. Even the level of witchcrafts in North America, who can stand it? The level of occultism going on in this North America, who can stand it? So let no man make you believe that, because the system is like this, though, so there is no enemies, there is no wicked. What about people practicing astral projectors? Do you think it's a form? It's not a form. Magic power, sorceries are not form. White witch. White witchcraft is not a form. Kipasukuli by hand in rubber sika break it by yaba. Kapuse ketukuria kata by yaba. Have you had, I think it's common here in North America when people say they are hearing voices and they begin to give the person maybe medication. Kisrovenia. When somebody is suffering from Kisrovenia, they say, I'm telling you, it's an activity of the devil. That devil is a bastard. Only the voice of God will we hear. Only the voice of God will we obey. In the name of Jesus. That's why I've told us before, there are a lot of voices. It takes those who are plugged into the socket of the Holy Spirit to be able to hear the voice of God. Because there are a lot of voices out there. What am I saying tonight in the name of Jesus? We are praying. We'll be praying tonight quickly. I may not be able to finish what I have here tonight. Maybe by the grace of God, next week, Thursday, we will pray. I don't know if Holy Spirit says we should repeat it. We should continue in the silencing the voice of our adversary. Fine. But if Holy Spirit gives us another direction, it is very fine. I'm a servant. By the grace of God, I'm a servant. So I'm under his command. Brethren, the Bible says your adversary. The Bible says, your adversary, the devil. So, some people normally think that, if I don't fight the devil, some tush, can I call them some police Christians? Okay, if I don't cast out the devils, devil won't go after me. If I don't do this to the devil, if I don't knock at his door, it's not going to bang at my door. If I just go my way, I just go my way like this as a Christian, just go to heaven and allow Satan to go on his own way also, and everything is just okay. You are a liar. The Bible says you adversary the devil. Do you think the devil will allow that person to be going this way? Even if you are not looking, can I tell you this tonight? If you are not looking for trouble, trouble is looking for you. Think about that. If you are not looking for trouble, you are not looking for trouble. How many of us wrote a letter to coronavirus to come? So coronavirus, I want to see your face. How many people wrote the letter?
So let this mind, let this one enter into you, to your subconscious. If you are not looking for trouble, trouble is looking for you. If you are not looking for Satan, Satan is busy walking up and down the road looking for you. The Bible says, seeking whom he may devour. So he's looking for anybody to destroy. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter your personality. It doesn't matter whether you are president or you are prime minister or you are premier or you are counselor. Satan is not a respecter of status. He can mesmerize anybody at any point. But I pray for somebody tonight. Satan will not win the battle over your life. What am I saying? From where we read, the Bible says, but he delivers Jesus into their will. Ah, I pray tonight in the name of Jesus, God will not deliver you into the will of your enemies. No, the Bible says in Psalm 55 verse 9, the Bible says, destroy, O Lord, and scatter their tongues. Brethren, there are some tongues that have been gathered to pull you down. There are some voices that have been gathered to make sure that you don't make it to heaven. There are some voices that have been gathered to make sure that life is not convenient for you. But whether that devil likes it or not, whether that devil likes it or yes, in the name that above the name, we will make heaven. We will fulfill destiny. In the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, time will fail me because I have about 4 examples of the people, the voices of the adversaries prevail over them in the scripture. I've only touched one, the Lord Jesus Christ. So I deliberately chose the Lord Jesus Christ so that if the voices of the adversary could prevail over the man Jesus, the man that was born without intercourse, the man that was born holy, if the man should be killed, if he could be killed just like that, just know that every one of us, every other person on this planet Earth, every other person is in for trouble, is in for battle. Destroy, O Lord, and divide their tongues, that is, scatter their voices. For I have seen violence and strife in the city. Even that is one of the reasons why some people are your adversaries. I will just jump something so that we can pray tonight. How do they operate? Quickly, let's look at the operation of this one. These people, they want to discredit your person. Adversary wants to discredit your person. He wants to make sure that you are not, he wants to make sure that your personality does not hold water anywhere. That you don't have a quality life to live. They want to discredit you. They want to make you like you are just useless. They want to useless you even before those who are supposed to help your destiny. They want to criticize you in all angles. Adversary criticizes in all angles. Adversary criticizes everything you do in the presence of your adversary. Cause for criticism. There is nothing you do that is good to your adversary. That's why when you see somebody criticizing you every now and then, whether at the workplace, whether in the city, whether anywhere, right then, this person, only thing that this person does against you is to criticize you. Put a question mark at the back of that person's name or face. Know that that person doesn't want good for you. That is your adversary. It is your adversary. And it is not all about him. It's about the Satan that is using him or her against you. Hallelujah. What about character assassination? Slander. That's another thing they do. They assassinate people's character. They destroy your person behind you. They destroy your person. When they are assassinating you, these people will be alive. When they are assassinating you, maybe he's at the workplace or in the church, even when you are coming, when they are talking about you, they keep quiet. When they are talking about you and you are coming, they change the topic. That's the way they operate. Meanwhile, they have sown the seed. Well, let me tell you something tonight, brethren. Voice can be planted as a seed into someone's life. The voice can be planted as a seed into someone's life. That's why you must be careful the kind of voices that you are listening to. The Bible says in Matthew, I think somewhere in Matthew chapter 13, verse 25, that when men slept, the enemy came to sow tears. So voice also can be so, can be put in, into the ground of somebody's life. I decree every evil word that has been sown into your life tonight. I mean, that has been sowed into your life. Every evil word that has been sowed into your life, Holy Ghost fire will consume it in the name of Jesus. What about unnecessary envy? It doesn't matter your position. It doesn't matter even whether one of the things that is common at the workplace is some people who are earning more money than you, they begin to envy you. They are the one they begin to envy you. Meanwhile, they have more money than you, but they make jealous of you because the way you have structured your life, the quality of life that you are living, the way God is, the blessing of God is on your life. They begin to envy they are just jealous. When you see them, you will see the jealousy on their faces. When you see them, you will see it. But most of the time, these people, they don't know it. They don't know that so many people know. Or they don't know that the victim also know. Hallelujah. Kapaseto roba yagaba. Or when you share good news with somebody and the person is sad, or the countenance became negative immediately, just know that that person is the enemy of your progress. And finally, in that, they nurture offenses towards you unnecessarily. Whatever you say makes them to be offended. Everything from your mouth is offense. Everything from you to them is offense. All what they are looking for around your life is offense. They might not be able to point to any area where your life has blessed them. They might not be able to point to any area where you have been a blessing to them. You might not be able to point to any area where you have rescued them from evil. But they be able to point to 1,001 areas where you have not been able to do anything. So where you are making them to be mad. So they live on offenses perpetually, and they end up in hell at the end of the day, because the spirit behind offense or offenses is satanic. You can't be speaking in tongue and be not showing offenses. That's why I said something some time ago, that Holy Ghost will never inspire you to pull another person down. When you are having inspiration of somebody falling or somebody being destroyed, just know that you are already working for devil without appointment letter. Just know that Satan has given you job to do, and it's not going to pay you. The reward for that, the reward for that thing is destruction. Which voice are you listening to? Plug yourself to the voice of the Holy Spirit. You will not be able to hear the nonsense that Satan is doing out there. I pray for somebody tonight as we begin to pray. In the name of Jesus, heaven will open. Every voice of the enemy is raging in your life. The Bible says even that it will deliver us from the noisome pestilence. Coronavirus also has a voice. One of the voices of coronavirus is spirit of fear. Some people are afraid now. Even, especially in North America right now, some people are now in pieces. They have been scattered into pieces. The center could not hold again. Falcon cannot bear the falcon. Things fall apart. Their lives are falling apart. I want to encourage somebody tonight. Hold on to God. It doesn't matter what coronavirus is doing out there. It is not your portion. Hold on to God. Don't let your life be scattered. Don't let your life fall apart because of the voice of coronavirus. Don't let your life fall apart. Don't let your finances fall apart. Don't let your marriage fall apart. Don't let the life of your children fall apart. Don't let your career fall apart. Hold on. Look at opportunity in the adversity in this season. I think we need to stop there tonight so that we can pray. I want us to go before the Lord now and begin to worship Him and begin to adore Him. Let's begin to bless His holy name, Lord God Almighty. Lord, I worship You because of who You are. I give You glory because of who You are. I give You praise. Because of who You are, Lord, I lift my voice to say, Lord, I worship You. Because of who You are. Que posuka payate rebozu kadayaba. Let's go ahead and worship Him. Let's go ahead and bless His holy name.
Paso kete katoro maza katabaya gadabayaba. Giving glory, giving honor, giving adoration. Masenta koremba kasante keru maya gadabaya gadaba. Leka baba baba basi kete boyogodo baya gadabaya gadaba. Lord, we worship you. We give you all the glory. We give you all the adoration in the name of Jesus. Blessed be your name. Blessed be your name. Blessed be your name. Mika paso koto baya gadabaya gadabaya. Father, we worship you, Lord. In the name of Jesus. Father, we worship you, Lord. In the name of Jesus. Give him glory. Magnify his holy name. In the name of Jesus. Blessed be your name, O God, in the name of Jesus. There is no one like you. Father, we worship you. We worship you, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Thank you for tonight. Thank you for tonight, Lord. Thank you for tonight, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Father, we worship you, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Let us thank God for the voice of the Lord in our lives. Go ahead and thank God for the voice of the Lord in your life. Go ahead and thank God for the voice of the Lord in your life. To go ahead and thank God for the voice of the Lord in your life. Lord, I thank you for your voice in my life. According to Psalm 29, verse 1 to 9, I thank you for your voice. Your voice that is majestic in nature. Your voice that breaketh the cedar of Lebanon. Your voice that is upon many waters. Lord, I thank you for your voice. Because no power of darkness can silence you. No demon can silence your voice, oh God. Oh God Almighty, I give all the glory, I give all the honor, I give adoration in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, I thank you. Can I remind somebody tonight as we continue thanking God that the first weapon that God used in the Garden of Eden was the weapon of his voice in Genesis chapter 1 verse 3. In Genesis chapter 1 verse 3, that was the voice, the first weapon that God used is the voice, is the weapon of his voice. It's the weapon of his voice. The weapon of his voice. And the Bible says, and God said, let there be light. Let there be light. Psalm 29 verse 1 to 9. That is where you can find the characteristics of the voice of God. Psalm 29 verse 1 to 9. That's where you will find it. That's where you can find it. And I'm talking about the weapon of voice of the first weapon that God used in the Garden of Eden was the weapon of his voice. Because he said, Bible says, and let there be light. And God said, his voice was released. That is why if you read in the Genesis chapter 3 verse 8, Adam said, and the Bible says, the voice of the Lord, I heard thy voice in the garden. The voice of the Lord came into the garden in the cool of the day. The voice asked, oh God Almighty, let's go ahead and thank him for his voice. Lord, I thank you for your voice. In my life, in my family, I thank you for your voice. Father, I thank you for your voice. I thank you for your voice. I thank you for your voice. Kapaso tokere ba yagada ba yaba yaba. In the name of Jesus. Hey, kapasa katayon doro ba yaba. Let us go ahead right now and pray and say, Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray against every voice of adversaries in my life, every voice of the wicked, every voice of the wicked in my life, in my family. I pray against it tonight in the name of Jesus. Re katabasa katabaya gataba katabayaba. I pray against the voice of the wicked. I pray against the voice of the wicked. Any area of my life where the voice of the adversary is raging, where the voice of the wicked is raging, I silence it. I silence it. I silence the voice of the wicked in my life tonight. In the mighty name of Jesus, in my family, in my ministry, in my destiny, I silence the voice of the wicked. In the name of Jesus, Lord, I silence the voice of the wicked. In the name of Jesus, in every department of my life, in every area of my life, oh Lord God Almighty, tonight I silence the voice of the wicked. In the name of Jesus, every evil voice that is being raised against me, I silence you in the name of Jesus. I silence you in the name of Jesus. Somebody pray tonight in the name of Jesus that every evil voice being raised against you from the water kingdom, from the marine kingdom, from the air kingdom, from anywhere, any satanic voice being raised against your life, against your family tonight, Lord, I silence them in the name of Jesus. Some people that suffer from all manner of demonic addictions, is the voice they are hearing that is pushing them not to be able to get deliverance. Pray tonight in the name of Jesus. In any area where satanic voice is controlling my life, I silence that evil voice in the name of Jesus. Some people, they will have done one evil or the other, or one negative thing or the other, before they realize it. Why? Because they are yielding to
a voice. They are yielding to a voice that is controlling them. They are yielding to a voice of familiar spirit. Every evil voice controlling my life, every evil voice influencing my life negatively, I silence you in the name of Jesus. I silence you in the name of Jesus. My life, I declare tonight, you shall not yield to the voice of the adversary. From today, my life, you shall not obey the voice of the adversary. My ministry, you shall not obey the voice of the adversary. My finances, you shall not obey the voice of the adversary. My health, you shall not obey the voice of the adversary. My career, you shall not obey the voice of the adversary. In the name of Jesus, I kapasakatabaya rokete basoka prekete kariaba. My situation shall hear the voice of God. My circumstance shall hear the voice of God. My situation shall hear the voice of God. My circumstance shall hear the voice of God. My sekatabaya baya. Rokete basoka baya gada. Rakete basakataya. Rokete bakatagada. Rokotogada baya. I declare to that, Lord God Almighty, every satanic voice influencing my destiny, influencing my life so negatively, I silence you in the name of Jesus. I silence you. My life shall not hear the voice of adversary anymore. My life shall not yield to the voice of adversary anymore. In the name of Jesus. Do you know a spell is a voice? Do you know a spell is cast by the use of a voice? A spell is cast by the use of a voice. Pray tonight in the name of Jesus. Every spell of the wicked cast against my life, I silence you. I arrest you. I arrest you in the name of Jesus. I arrest you. Que possa taya recapa prekete koto. Spell is an output of a voice. Que riba satayando e prakatu ziketeya recapa posoke prekete rokoto katabaya gada. I silence every voice of spell, every voice of incantation, every voice of magic, every voice of incantation in my life. I silence you in the name of Jesus. Every voice of witchcraft, I silence you in my life in the name of Jesus. I silence you in the name of Jesus. I silence you in the name of Jesus. Ragada basagada baya baya ba. Reka break it doso kodo baya baya ba. I want you to pray tonight that I raise the blood of Jesus. Pray that I raise the blood of Jesus against every evil decrease in my life, against every evil decrease and command in my life. I raise the blood of Jesus against them. The Bible talks about the blood of Jesus that speaks, the blood that speaks better thing than the blood of Abel. The blood has a voice, brethren. The blood of Jesus has a voice. Pray tonight that, Lord, let my life hear the voice of Jesus. Let my life hear the voice of the blood of Jesus. The voice of the blood of Jesus is the blood of is the voice of mercy, is a voice of deliverance. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray tonight, oh God, in the name of Jesus, every evil decree, every evil decree operating in my family, operating in my life, I silence you. I arrest you by the blood of Jesus. I lift up the blood of Jesus against you. I lift up the blood of Jesus against you. Every satanic decree, every witchcraft decree, every witchcraft decree, occultic decree against my life, I lift up the blood of Jesus against you. Kapahuli kataya, rikata sokatabaya, iketo kodo maya gadabaya. Every voice of witchcraft, the voice of wizards, the voice of astral projectors, the voice of occultic people, in the name of Jesus, territorial spirit, environmental demons, your voice tonight, I lift all the blood of Jesus against you. I lift all the blood of Jesus against you. I lift all the blood of Jesus against you. Geographical strong man, I lift all the blood of Jesus against you. Territorial evil spirits, I lift all the blood of Jesus against you. Environmental evil spirits, I lift all the blood of Jesus against you. In the mighty name of Jesus, rakata basagada gada gada gada, yeka paposoke prekete gada, yeka kurokoto gada 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 gada, laka prekete gada gada. I want to tell somebody tonight: if the voice of man cannot prevail against your life, that man cannot prevail against you. It takes the voice that is prevailed for the person to prevail. That is why That's why we need to pray tonight that, Lord, in the name of Jesus, man shall not prevail against me. Hey, enemy shall not prevail against me. When their voices prevailed against Jesus, Jesus was put to death. Thank God for the resurrection. Thank God for the resurrection. That is the waterloo of their voices. But the voices prevailed against the man Jesus. The man Jesus couldn't survive the effect of their voices. Let's pray tonight in the name of Jesus. Father, I reverse by the blood of Jesus every incantation, every evil voice, by the blood of Jesus. Every evil voice that has been spoken against me, that has been spoken against my family, that has been spoken against my marriage, that has been spoken against my marital destiny, that has been spoken against my future, every evil word that enemies have spoken, I reverse it. The voice of the enemy shall not succeed. The voice of the wicked shall not succeed in my life. In the mighty name of Jesus. There are people they will have done better in life. There are people they will have fulfilled destinies in life. But the voice of the adversary has been planted into their life. The voice of the wicked, wicked people, the wicked have planted evil into their life. They planted the satanic activities. They planted demonic activities as a seed into their life. That's why they couldn't go further in life. Pray to God tonight in the name of Jesus. Any seed, the seed of the voice of the wicked in my life, I uproot you. The Bible says every tree that my father has not planted shall be uprooted. Pray in the name of Jesus. Tonight, oh God, I uproot every seed of Satan. I uproot every seed of the wicked in my life, in my family, in the name of Jesus. Every evil seed that the wicked has planted in my life, Father, tonight, in the name of Jesus, I uproot it, oh God. I uproot it in the name of Jesus. 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 I uproot every seed of the wicked in the mighty name of Jesus. In any area of my life, tonight I uproot it, oh God, in the name of Jesus. I uproot it, oh God, in the name of Jesus. I decree, henceforth, in the name of Jesus, let no evil voice trouble me. Let no evil voice trouble my family. Let no evil voice trouble my destiny. Let no evil voice trouble my ministry. In the name of Jesus, rekata kasakala boyosh, leka preketo zukudu bayaga dabaya, rekata basaka dabo dogo, rakata basaka dabaya gadabaya bayaba, rekata basaka dabaya gadabaya, reka brekete gesegedegedegede, rakata gasaka daba. Every evil voice that is growing up with me, I arrest you. I silence you by the blood of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Blessed be your name. Blessed be your name, O God, the name of Jesus. Let's begin to magnify the name of the Lord. Let's begin to bless Him. Let's begin to magnify Him. I want us to pray quickly. I want us to pray for the nations of the world. I want us to pray. This is the map of the world in my hand. I want us to just pray as we stretch for our hands. Just pray. Whether you can pray in the Holy Ghost, whether you can pray in understanding, just pray for the nations of the world. That Lord, the world, globally, there is crisis. Oh Lord, come and save the world. Oh Lord, come and have mercy. In the name of Jesus. Father, heal our land. Heal all these lands. Heal all these continents. In the mighty name of Jesus. Father, heal this continent. Oh God, in the precious name of Jesus, heal the continents of the world in the name of Jesus. Let the voice of the adversary be silenced in all the nations of the world in the name of Jesus. The nations are already realizing it, that Jesus is the answer, that only God is only God they can find hope. Let's pray for the nations of the world, that Lord God Almighty, let there be healing in these lands, in these lands that make up the whole world. Let there be healing, oh God. Let there be healing. Remove confusion. There is another thing that the voice of the wicked can do, is to sow confusion into somebody's life. That's why some people are confused right now. Oh Lord, let there be a way out. Oh Lord, out of this COVID-19 issue, let there be a way out. Let there be healing. Let there be deliverance. Let there be healing. Let there be deliverance for the nations of the world. In the name of Jesus, as I lift up, oh Lord. This map of the world to represent, oh God Almighty, in the name of Jesus, remove the confusion of COVID-19. There are a lot of theories and there are things people are saying. Oh Lord God Almighty, in the name of Jesus, Lord, let there be healing, let there be a way out. Mase katuli kahaya, rekatuza kapahali guzu prakatabaya, mezuzu katayanda rabayaba. Father, this is the map of the world, Lord. Let there be healing, oh Lord, let there be healing across the world. Let there be supernatural way out to God. Let there be supernatural. supernatural way out, oh God. Let there be supernatural way out, Lord. Let there be supernatural way out, Lord. This death will not lead to death, oh Lord. Maso koto bayaka rabazi kata yaboshia. Ezuke papre keto zushi. Lekanda kahali. Rande zize keke porua kataya. Menekua. Elika tu zaka kakuku. Yerike tizakata. Rebrake tu kakaya. Le zize kata hali. Ike tu baba poso. Yereka daga 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 daga. In the precious name of Jesus. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Blessed be your name, O God. Lord, we worship you, Lord. Father God Almighty, in the name of Jesus. Hey, Father, we worship you. You are the King of Zion. You are the Lord of hosts. Blessed be your name. Blessed be your name, O God. Lord, let there be a way out for the whole world. Let there be deliverance in the name of Jesus. Lord, we worship you. Let's go ahead and worship him and give him glory. Father, we worship you, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Father, we worship you, Lord, in the name of Jesus. We worship you, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Father, we worship you, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Father, we worship you, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Father, we worship you, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Blessed be your name. Blessed be your name. Father, we worship you, Lord. We give all the glory. We give all the praise. My Father, we worship you, Lord. Lord, we thank you. We thank you for tonight. We magnify your name for tonight. We bless your name for tonight. We magnify you again, oh Lord. We lift your name on high. Hallelujah to your name. Hallelujah to your name. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, King of Kings. Thank you, King of Kings. Thank you, Lord of Lords. Hallelujah to your name. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we are prayed. Amen, amen, and amen. Oh, Father, we want to thank you for the opportunity of this of your presence tonight. We thank you for helping us. We thank you for everything, for all things you have done. May your name be highly exalted in the name of Jesus. Oh Lord God Almighty, as we continue tonight, Father, oh Lord God Almighty, as we continue the remaining activities of our life, maybe those who are going to bed right now in North America, or those who just waking up in Africa or any parts of the world right now, in the name of Jesus, we pray any voice of the wicked, the voice of the adversary that has been prevailing or that has been raging in your life, by the blood of Jesus, by the blood of Jesus, and in unity of faith, we arrest it tonight in the name of Jesus. Henceforth, let no evil voice trouble you, because you bear upon your body the mark of the Lord Jesus. Your life, my life, we hear the voice of the Lord in the name of Jesus. Every voice of witchcraft, spell, voodoo, magic, sorcery, wizardry that have been raised against our lives, tonight we raise the blood of Jesus against them in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, anyone, any group of people or individual that have said that it is with our mouth we will destroy them, it is with our mouth we will destroy them, I decree in the name of Jesus, Holy Spirit, we raise standard against them. Because the Bible says, when the enemy shall come against you like a flood, the Spirit of the Lord will raise standard against them. Therefore, tonight, in the name of Jesus, by the Spirit of the Lord, we raise standard against every evil voice, the voice of witchcraft, the voice of the enemies, the voice of affliction and sickness, we raise standard against them. Oh Lord God Almighty, we pray tonight for the global world. Father God Almighty, in the name of Jesus, come and heal the lands, oh God. Come and heal our lands in the name of Jesus. All over the world, Father, come and heal our hands in the name of Jesus. Let deliverance come to North America. Let deliverance come. Oh Lord, let your deliverance come to South America. Let your deliverance come, oh Lord, to Central America. Let your deliverance come to Australia. Let your deliverance come to Africa. Let your deliverance come to Europe. Let your deliverance come to United Kingdom. Let your deliverance come, oh God, to Asia. Let your deliverance come to the Middle East. Let your deliverance come, oh God, to Caribbean and Pacific. Let your deliverance come even to Greenland in the name of Jesus. Father, heal our land, oh Lord. Let this coronavirus become a thing of the past, oh God. Wipe it out supernaturally, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, glorious Father. From this night, I decree and I declare, no voice of the wicked will prevail in your life.
No voice of the wicked will prevail in your family in the name of Jesus. In your health, the voice of the wicked will not prevail. I decree and I declare tonight, I declare tonight, by the power of the more almighty God, in the name that is above all names, the word of the enemies shall not prevail over you, in the mighty name of Jesus. I decree and I declare tonight, in the name of Jesus, the word of the wicked shall not be established in your life, in the name of Jesus. The word of the evil ones shall not be established in your life, in the name of Jesus. All over the world there shall be healing, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Blessed be your name, O God, in the name of Jesus. We worship you, Lord, we magnify you, for we pray in Jesus' name. Amen, amen, and amen. God bless you all. God keep you. God be gracious unto you. I thank you all for joining this prayer session tonight. And I believe next week, Friday, will be the last day of this kind of prayer session for this month. And by the grace of God, next week, Friday, also supposed to be our monthly night vigil. So by the grace of Almighty God, the prayer will be longer than 1 hour next week, by the grace of God. Let's prepare and ready to talk to our Maker, who will help us, who will deliver us, who will heal our land, in the name of Jesus. And I pray for somebody, when this holocaust of coronavirus is over, nobody will be missing in your life. Even you yourself will not be missing. Nobody will be missing in your family. Nobody will be missing around your life, in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you all. God bless you. In North America, have a good night rest. In Africa, over there, and anywhere, good morning to you all. God bless you. Bye. Thank you.